In this tutorial, I will show you how to set up a simple model of a steam turbine for power generation. All the components that we need are located in the H2O subsystems section of the icon bar. And so I scroll down first to select my steam turbine. I click on it once with the mouse and then I place it on the screen, and I click again with the left mouse button to have it located on the flow sheet. Then I need a source for my live steam, which will flow to the turbine, and a sink for the outgoing steam, which will subsequently flow to a condenser. If it flows downwards, I can rotate this icon with the object's rotate command, or just simply by clicking Ctrl R for rotating this component. Then I connect my components by clicking on the terminal with the left mouse button, and then I'm in the so-called line drawing mode. I draw a straight line, and when I want to end this segment and go downwards or upwards, I click once with the mouse button on the screen, and then I connect to the incoming terminal of the turbine. From the turbine, I click on the terminal and go to this downward facing. Additionally, to produce electrical power, I need a generator, which is located in the machinery section of the icon bar. I click on the generator, place it on the screen, and connect the turbine and the generator with a shaft. That's my simple flow sheet of the steam turbine. And now I will start parameterizing this process. If I run a calculation now, IPSE automatically detects that certain parameters are missing. Parameters are required input from the user. Here in these white boxes in the data dialog, you see that electrical efficiency and mechanical efficiency must be put in. If I do not have an idea what to put in, I can click on Load Defaults. I choose not to override any existing values, and then my parameters are entered for this component, for the generator. I can again run a calculation, and for the turbine there is also a parameter missing, eta m. I load defaults. Again, I do not override any existing values, and I click on OK, and then I'm halfway done already. Running a calculation now starts the numerical solver, and the solver tries to find a solution. Here it tells me, okay, there are one errors and two warnings, and I can check in the protocol by selecting yes, and then with the next error I come instantly to the warning that the system is undefined. 17 equations, 21 variables, and the so-called settings analysis counts that the degrees of freedom are 4, which is written here. So the system cannot be fully solved, but a few more variables have to be set. I can choose from these variables. Here it is written in text, but on the screen the settings analysis shows me instantly which variables I can set. And here it's quite obvious. I will first choose my live steam conditions to set them. So I remove the settings analysis results and double click here on the source. And here for live steam conditions, I set pressure of 40 bars and 440 degrees Celsius. This will be typical values for an industrial steam turbine. And then I also set a mass flow of, let's say, 30 kilograms per second. This is roughly what is produced by a 100 tons per hour steam generator. Clicking OK. So I have set three variables and then I click OK. If I run a calculation now, you see some of the values are now shown in black. They are correct results, but there is still one error. I have now reduced the degrees of freedom from 4 to 1. So one more setting is missing. This is automatically detected by the settings analysis. And here I can see, okay, these settings analysis results. You see the inlet conditions are now fully specified. Outlet conditions or also power is to be set, but let's choose the pressure level at the sink. So this is what will later on go to a condenser. I set the pressure level to 50 millibars. Run a calculation again. And now I have a correct result. No errors anymore. If I want to see what is displayed here on these data crosses, I can go to the objects menu and say add a reference cross, first for my water stream. This is the W stream, which I place here as a reference cross. And then I insert for here for the shaft another reference cross. Okay, it is also placed in the lower left corner and I can move it to any place I want on the flow sheet. So you can see here power is displayed in megawatts because I have converted kilowatt to megawatt already. Okay, so this is working. If I want to now to change my specification, I could first I choose the command import estimates for all objects, and then I have all the calculation results available in the data dialogs of the individual objects. And now, let's say instead of producing 31 megawatts of power, I set this to produce 40 megawatts of power. It is clear now I have put in an additional setting, and if I run a calculation now, there will be a so-called overspecification. The solver detects this overspecification, saying the system is overspecified, and identifies a few variables which are in conflict with each other. So what I have to do is to remove one of these conflicting settings. I remove my mass flow setting, and now the calculation can be done again without errors. And now I, instead of having the original 30 kilograms per second, I need 38.49 kilograms per second expanding through the turbine. So that's it for now. Thanks for watching.